In this video, we're going to complete numbers 7 and 8 on the CUDA Software Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, Center and Spread of Data. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Now, our directions are the same as 1 through 6. We're going to find the mode, median, mean, lower and upper quartiles, the interquartile range, and the standard deviation. However, before we jump into number 7, let's understand this histogram. What it's saying is that in game 1, there were 7 goals. In game 2, there was 1 goal. In game 3, there was 3 goals, and so on. All the way up to the 15th game, there was 7 goals. So let's write our data down below, starting with the least amount of goals scored. And that was in game 2. In game 2, there was 1 goal scored. Next, the least amount of goals scored was 3. And that happened in game 3. It happened in game 4, it happened in game 6, and game 9. So the frequency of 3 goals scored was 4 games. Now the next value, you can see just as there was no 2 goal games, there was no 4 goal games. However, there's 1, 2, 3, 5 goal games. So 5. 5 and 5 will go into our data list, so we'll cancel out game 5, game 8 was also 5 goals, and game 13. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more games to take into account the amount of goals scored. So next is a 6 goal game, which there are 2 6 goal games, that's game 7 and game 14. So I'll write 6 down in my list twice, so canceling out game 7 and game 14, and then finally, there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 games of 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, writing down 5 sevens. And that takes care of all of the games. So first we're going to find our mode, now that we've got our data set. And the mode is the number that occurs the most, and you can see that 7 goals were scored the most, so 7 is our mode. Now we're going to find the median, which is that middle number. So going from lowest to highest, canceling out, then next lowest to next highest, and then so on, we will eventually reach our middle number, or middle two numbers, which in this case, our middle number is 5. So our median of our data set is 5. Now after the median, it makes sense to go ahead and calculate quartile 1 and quartile 3, the lower and upper quartiles. That way, we can then calculate our IQR. So quartile 1 is the middle number of the lower half of our data, where this 5 is not included because it is exactly in the middle. So canceling out 1, 5, 3, 5, 3, 3, we'll get 3 as that value for quartile 1. Next, we'll calculate quartile 3, the upper quartile. So canceling out 6, 7, 6, 7, 7, 7, 7 will be our middle number. So 7 is that upper quartile, quartile 3. Now for the interquartile range, that's Q3 minus Q1. So that's going to be 7 minus 3, which is equal to 4. So the IQR is 4 in number 7. Now let's calculate the mean. The mean is each of the values, so each of the goals, added together and then divided by the amount that we summed together, which there's 15 values because there were 15 separate games. So we know that the goals of the games summed together divided by 15 will be the average. And this is the average goal in a game of hockey. So adding 1 to 4 threes and then to 3 fives to 2 sixes and then to 5 sevens, we'll get 75, and that's divided by 15, which 75 divided by 15 is 5. So the mean in number 7 is 5, and that's 1 plus 4 times 3 plus 3 times 5 plus 2 times 6 plus 5 times 7 divided by 15. Now let's calculate that standard deviation represented by sigma. The standard deviation is the square root of 1 over our count n times the sum of each of the data points, subtracting the mean, and then squaring that value. So that's going to be 1 minus 5 squared plus 3 minus 5 squared plus 3 minus 5 squared, and so on, all the way up to 7 minus 5 squared. So once we add each of those values together, we'll divide it by n, which is 15, and then take the square root to get our standard deviation. Lucky enough for us, we have an online calculator that we can type the data into and see the steps as we go along. So I like to use the Math is Fun calculator, and I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this calculator. But typing in our numbers, we have 1, 3, 3, 3, 3, 5, 5, 5, 6, 6, and then 5 sevens. 7, 7, 7, 7, 7. And to double check, in this first teal box, our count is 15, the sum of our data is 75, and the mean was 5. Now you can see this first box labeled differences. Negative 4 is 1 minus the mean, negative 2 is 3 minus the mean, and so on. But once we square those values, we'll get this next box and the values within that box. And if we sum those values, we'll get 54. And then when we divide that by the count, we'll get 3.6. However, that's the variance. We still need to take the square root, which will give us 1.897, which rounds to 1.90, which we'll write as 1.9. So in number 7, our mode is 7, our median's 5, our mean is 5, quartile 1 and 3 are 3 and 7, our interquartile range is 4, and our standard deviation is 1.9. Let's continue on to number 8. Now in number 8, we have a stem and leaf plot, and we need to take into account the key. The stem is going to be the thousands place, and our leaf is our hundreds place. So when we list out our data, we'll have 100, 200, 300 three times, then 800, 900, 1,800, 2,200, 2,400, 2,900, then again 2,900, 3,200, 3,300, 3,800, and then lastly 4,800. So now let's look at our mode. Our mode is our number that occurs to most, and looking within our stem and leaf plot, you can see that that's going to be the threes, which represent 300. So our mode is 300. Next, we'll find our median, which we can go ahead and continue using the stem and leaf plot for. So canceling out our least number, then our greatest, next least, next greatest, and so on. We'll have the number between 1800 and 2200. So adding 1,800 to 2,200, and then dividing that by 2, we will get 2,000. And note that 1,800 and 2,200 are 400 units apart, or 400 degrees Celsius apart, and 400 divided by 2 would be 200. So adding 200 to 1,800, or subtracting 200 from 2,200, we'll get 2,000. So I'll go ahead and write in my table that 2,000 is that median. Now after the median, I'll go ahead and find quartile 1 and quartile 3. So looking for quartile 1, in my first half of the data, I'll cancel out 1, 8, 2, 9, 3, 8, and then I'm left with 3 and 3, which represent 300 and 300. Therefore, quartile 1 is 300. So my upper half of the data, that middle number, canceling out 2, 8, 4, 8, 9, 3, then it's going to be between 9 and 2, where that 9 represents 2,900 and that 2 represents 3,200. So 2,900 plus 3,200, dividing that by 2, we're finding the halfway point between those two numbers. So 2,900 plus 3,200 divided by 2 is 3,050. So 3,050 is quartile 3. Now we can find our IQR since we have quartile 3 and quartile 1. The IQR is Q3 minus Q1, which is 3050 minus 300. 3050 minus 300 is going to give us 2750. So the IQR in number 8 is 2750. Now let's go on to the mean. For the mean, we're going to sum all of these values and then divide it by the number of values that we're summing. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 different values. So typing each of these into our calculator, summing them together, we'll get 30,200. So 30,200 over 16 will be our mean. And when we divide that number by 16, we get 1,887.5. So 1,887.5 is the average for our data set in number 8. Now we'll find the standard deviation, which writing the formula for the standard deviation will be the square root of 1 over our count of n, which we know is 16, times the sum, starting with our first data value all the way up until the last data value. We're going to take those values, subtract the mean, and then square it. But we're summing that all together and then dividing by n. So that's going to be 100 minus the mean squared plus 200 minus the mean squared plus 300 minus the mean squared and so on to 4,800 minus the mean squared, dividing that summation by 16 and then taking the square root. That'll give us the standard deviation. However, to make this easier, let's go ahead and use a calculator online. So now we just have to enter the values for our data into the numbers box. So we have 100, 200, 300. So double checking with this second box, our count is indeed 16. The sum of those values was 30,200 and our mean was 1,887.5. Now here are the differences when we take our values within our data set and subtract the mean from each of those. And then here is the box where we square those differences. And then when we sum those differences together, and then when we sum those squared differences together, we get 34,037,500. Dividing that by 16, we get our variance and we take the square root of that number, which was 2,127,343. When we take the square root of that, we'll get 1,458.54 for our standard deviation. So again, our standard deviation in number 8 is 1,458.54. And that is our solution in number 8. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, or if you just want to leave me a note, put it in the comments below as well. Continue on to the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 9 and 10. And if you haven't done so already, like, subscribe, and share. Don't forget to do that before continuing on.